I just think it's is from my grandmother's house. This print my art professor at college did and gave to me. This print I did while I was taking printmaking in college, and the print below it, one of my classmates did, and I loved the Grand Canyon, so I feel like it was on the theme. I did that embroidery when I was a freshman in college, and I love to feel on my dragon plant. This is a print that I got from a local print artist of creatures that she sees in the park, which delighted me so much. I have my Rubik's Cube, my little ADHD fidget. Those are all over my house. I have a match, a loose match, absolute chaos. Oh yeah, and I'm saying hi in my TV. I got my TV for free. It was a big come up, I'll tell ya. I have all my yarn in that basket, and then I have all these overflow books down below in my TV console as well. So this pink chair came from a really good friend of mine who moved to Montana a few years ago. Now, this was before I had my own place, but she asked me if I wanted the pink chair. And at the time, I was living in my parents' house. And I was like, yeah, absolutely, I want the pink chair. And my parents were like, what the fuck? And I was like, no, 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 when I have my own apartment, the pink chair is coming with me. The chair has also been in her family for years and years, and so she wanted to make sure it was somewhere where she could still come visit it. Now we come to my shelves. This is a picture of me that's been in my bedroom as long as I can remember. And it has a button on it that my favorite coworker gave me before she knew I was a Taurus, but it says stubborn and kind. Here I have a stack of books that are on my nonfiction TBR. I have this leather and embers candle from Target, and all my fiction books next to it. And I have this awesome little hourglass that I got at IKEA. And I have this candle that's called Shut Up. I'm reading from Homebody Candles, and it smells so good. Down below, I forgot to mention a print made by a good friend of mine. His name is William, and he is an artist in the Twin Cities. And he did this print of the lakes at our college. Again, selfies in a mirror. Girl, what are you doing? So, moving on, I have my photo wall, which was way more trouble than it was worth, though it does look really good. That's a picture of me and my mom. This is a picture I took in Estonia, and I have pictures of my friends and just places that I've traveled in the world, and it makes me nostalgic for traveling whenever I look at it. So this is just another view of my little apartment, and as you can see, I had a party this weekend, and my friend knocked the fire extinguisher off of the wall. I'm really embarrassed. I've been a really responsible renter, except for that. In my kitchen, this piece of furniture is clutch for my small kitchen. My great aunt also gave it to me when she was moving, and it's a little rolling cart, and it is amazing. And then I have so many things on my fridge because this is like my goal aesthetic, is just to have a million amazing things on the fridge. And down below I have drawings and pictures from my students, which warms my heart every time I see them. My kitchen is pretty small. It's like galley style, kind of, but it works for me, and I love to cook in it. Over here I have my calendar, and my Cheerios, and my box that definitely doesn't have weed in it. I have my Mount Rainier poster, and my KitchenAid, which is like my child. My grandpa gave it to me when I moved into my apartment, because I think he realized it was going to be a long time until I got married. And I have a teeny little stove and dishwasher, and they work great. I'm also obsessed with. Above the sink, I have another print made by another friend, and it is an homage to our favorite pastry shop when we studied abroad in Australia. So this big, bulky cabinet houses my washer and dryer, and I'm really glad to have a washer and dryer, but this cabinet drives me fucking nuts. When I moved in, it was like my least favorite thing about the apartment, but now I hang my work back there, and get along fine. So this is what my apartment looks like from a different view, and I wanted to point out this very sweet postcard that my little brother sent me, with a scene from Ponyo in it. So now we're going to my bedroom, and I am obsessed with my bedroom. I recently built this canopy bed that I totally DIY'd, like Pinterest who, and oh, it's me in another mirror. Fancy that. So I've always wanted a canopy bed, and I kind of decided, like an inner child moment, to build myself one. And I just built it out of a giant embroidery hoop and a user.